Thank you for watching my video. My name is Mr. Chaswenike. In this video tutorial, we will discuss on resonant or tuned circuit application. They are all under capacitor as well. Remember, in our previous video, we discussed about sober capacitor. We also discussed on other pulse power capacitor and how they function. Please, if you have not watched that video, go to my YouTube channel Charles Electronics and watch the video. So in that case, let's go straight to our present topic. We will discuss resonant or tuned circuit applications, and we'll discuss major three major topic on this. Being another one is capacitive sensing application, and another one is a table of capacitor application. We will discuss these three major in this tutorial. So in that case, let's start from resonant or tuned circuit application. Now, in this design, to design fitters, we use capacitor, we use resistors, and also inductors. In this design, some combinations of components are used to amplify the resonant frequency signal. What I'm explaining here is this: before you design a resonant frequency, there must be some component that you will combine to design, and one of those components is capacitor. Capacitor must be there, resistors must be there, and also inductor must be there. These are the major components that you will use in designing. And you all know the work of capacitor, the work of resistors, and also the work of inductor. I will also discuss resistor in different topics. I'll also discuss inductor in another topic as well. But in this tutorial right now, I am discussing on capacitor. Now, what I'm trying to let you know, that without a capacitor, it means that the resonant frequency is incomplete. It won't work efficiently or the way you expected, because capacitor, it has a major role to play in that resonant frequency circuit. So for you to build, you must make the appropriate choice of combination of components, which involve resistors, inductors, and capacitors. And they all have value. Resistor, it has a value. Capacitor, it also has their own value. We have different types of capacitor as well. And inductor, it also has its own as well. So if you are to build a resonant circuit or a resonant frequency, you should be very careful and make the appropriate combination of the components. Now, in this case, the low power signal are amplified to the high power signal at resonant frequency. Such tuned fitters or insulators. It means that it filters from low signal amplified to high power signal amplified. That is just a simple explanation of it. It filters from the low power signal amplified to the high power signal amplified at resonant frequency. That is how it works, from low to high. But in designing the resonant frequency circuit, we take much care about the component combinations, because some of the combinations may damage the operation and also fail quickly. What am I trying to say? If you use or choose the wrong value of resistor, or you choose the wrong resistor, it means that that particular component, that particular circuit will damage. If you also use the wrong capacitor, it also means that the circuit will not work effectively and it will fail quickly. It's the same thing applicable to other components that is required to build a resonant frequency. Bear it in mind. Now we are to talk or discuss on capacitive sensing application. The capacitive sensing application is a technique in detecting the change in capacitance value, change in distance between the plates, change in dielectric, and change in the area of capacitor plates. I want you to understand something here. The capacitive sensing is a technique in detecting in the change in capacitance. Change in capacitance value, 1000 microfarad, 7000 microfarad, all depending. The function of that capacitive sensing technique is to detect when the capacitance has changed, as well as change in distance between the plate in between the positive and the negative, how it has shifted from right to left or from left to right. Another change is in dielectric. In that dielectric, you know that the only thing that determines the name of a capacitor or of a capacitor is the dielectric. The dielectric, it will determine the name of that particular capacitor, all depending on the dielectric that you are about to use. You can use aluminium, you can use any kind of thing, because in capacitor we have polarized and non-polarized as well. So in that case, the dielectric will determine the types of capacitor you are to construct or use. Change in the area of the capacitor plate. Change in the area of the capacitor plate. It's still the same thing as in between the plate. Change in the area of capacitor plate is where between the dielectric, where it plays. Between the dielectric, where it plays to separate the positive and the negative. And capacitive sensing is a technique which is recently used in advanced consumer electronic circuits. And where can we see those things? We can see it in our instrumentation. Let me show you where it is used. Now, although capacitive sensors are used in different applications, although capacitive sensors are used in different applications such as position, fluid level, humidity, acceleration, and manufacturing of quality control, all these things is used in terms of instrumentation. If you are good at instrumentation, you will know that these things, the fluid level, the humidity, the acceleration, and the manufacturing of quality control, they are all used in instrumentation circuits. Where if you are to talk of fluid, if you are to talk of oil, it could be oil, it could be anything, a liquid flow in a pipe. That is where this capacitive sensing is applied, because that is an advanced electronic consumer. That is what they have. Just to use the capacitor to sense out some certain things, the movement of liquid in the pipe. Now, in that case, we are to discuss on table of capacitor application. Table of capacitor application, which involve capacitor application and suitable types with reasons in terms of power supply. In terms of power supply smoothing, you will use aluminium, which is a polarized capacitor. We use aluminium, it is a polarized capacitor as well. It has a high capacitive and it has high capacity and high ripple current capacity. High ripple current capability, and we will also discuss high ripple current in due time as well. You can also use it in audio frequency. This audio frequency coupling, you can also use aluminium electrolytic capacitor, high capacitance. You can also use tantalum, the same thing. They are all these aluminium and tantalum, they are all in the family of polarized capacitor. Polarized capacitor, which means it has positive and negative. So in that case, it's small size and high capacitance. This polyester and / polycarbonate, they are non-polarized capacitors. They don't have negative, don't have positive. It means you can position it anyhow. So in that case, but values are not as high as electrolytic capacitor, which is aluminium. Radio frequency coupling capacitor application. You can also use ceramics COG. I will discuss this in ceramic capacitor, because ceramic capacitor is among of non-polarized capacitor as well. Ceramic X7 capacitor and polystyrene capacitor as well. They are all non-polarized capacitor, which what I mean by non-polarized capacitor, they don't have positive, they don't have negative. There is no indication of positive and negative. The same thing applicable to RF being radio frequency decoupling application. The same thing applies ceramic COG capacitor and ceramic S7RO capacitor. You can also use it in terms of decoupling frequency, radio frequency application. Tune cyclo, the same thing. Mica is another part of non-polarized capacitor as well. Non-polar capacitor as well, and the suitable and low but high cost. Ceramic COG, the same thing applicable. Therefore, if you are to build anything, if you are masterminding or planning to build, and that will involve a capacitor, always consider this table and put it in consideration. The value and every other thing, they are also important based on what you are to build. Thank you once again. My name is Mr. Charles Wenike. Thank you for watching my video. Please, if you like my video, subscribe to my channel, comment, and like. See you in the next class. Thank you once again. In the next class, we are going to discuss what is a capacitor. Thank you once again.